Welcome to Pots with Pans. My name is Jade Potts, and today I'm going to be showing you my recipe for banana crumb muffins. These are soft and tender with a crunchy cinnamon topping. If you have leftover bananas like I do, and they're not ripe, put them in a bag for a couple days, and they are perfect. Look at those. So my recipe starts with 3 ripe bananas. Perfect. We're going to add 3/4 of a cup of sugar to that. And now I'm just going to use the back of my fork to mash my bananas and my sugar together. And you can make this as chunky as you would like or as smooth as you want. This is a great way to use extra bananas that you have left over. We always have them at my house, so this is a great recipe that only takes about 10 minutes while your oven is preheating. All right, our next ingredient is going to be an egg. So we're just going to add that to this bowl. And I'm going to add a pinch of salt. And now I'm just going to combine these ingredients together just to break up that egg, stir them up just until combined. All right, now I'm going to add 1/3 cup of melted butter. Just give that another quick mix up. Okay, now for my dry ingredients in another bowl. So I'm going to add 1.5 cups of flour, as well as 1 teaspoon of baking soda and 1 teaspoon of baking powder. And we're just going to add this whole wet mixture on top of the dry mixture. And I'm gonna fold this together just until it's moistened. And that way you're ensuring that you have a nice tender muffin. If you overmix it, it's gonna be hard and not good. So make sure you just barely mix this till that flour gets incorporated. You can see it's already soaking it all up. All right, a little bit longer. All right, great. Okay, that looks good. I'm gonna get a muffin pan and I'm gonna line it with my paper liners. There we go. And I'm gonna use a little cooking spray, and that way your muffins come out really easily. So ice cream scoop, I'm gonna fill these up. And my last thing to do is make the topping. So 1/3 cup of brown sugar with 1/8 cup of flour, and about 1/8 teaspoon of cinnamon. I'm gonna put 1 tablespoon of cold butter, and then just use a pastry blender, or if you don't have one of those, just use a couple forks, or even just break it up with your fingers. This makes a rich, buttery, crunchy, cinnamony topping.